everybody. This is Tippy.
And this is Jo.
And you're listening to the Tippy Jo Show, sponsored by BetterHelp.com/the barn. If it's all right, I want to kick it with you all night, all night.
Always partying.
So we are minus somebody tonight.
Yeah.
Tina's not here with us this evening.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which makes it weird.
Does it?
A little bit, because then it's the Tippy Jo Show. How's the Tippy Jo Show with no Jo?
You make a good point. Tonight it's the Tippy Kyle Show.
Yeah. Got some exciting things to talk about, right?
Yes, I do, actually.
Yeah?
Yeah. First of all, have you heard about the scandal that Lizzo is in?
No.
Lizzo.
I know who Lizzo is.
Okay, yeah, yeah. I just had to say it again because the first time I said it didn't sound right coming out of my mouth. Just thought I'd give it another go. Anyway, so she's being sued by three of her former dance team members,
mm-hmm.
her backup dancers, I think they were. So, I mean, this story, there's like so many layers to it. And I know I'm the worst storyteller because I can't go from A to B. I have to go from like A to Q to R to B. And mm-hmm. then, you know, anyway, back on track.
Man, Lizzo's crazy.
That bitch wild. But anyway. So a couple of years ago, Lizzo was on a radio show and she was talking about how she would love to go to this place in Amsterdam that she had heard of, but she doesn't know the name of it. It's some kind of sex club in the red light district where the strippers and the talent allow you to eat bananas.
Oh, God.
From them. Yeah. So she was saying that, and the radio host was like, oh, that place is called Bananen Bar, and it's in Amsterdam. He, like, basically gave her the address, okay? This was a couple of years ago.
Okay.
So these three people are suing her, and they're saying that a couple years later, she took them to Amsterdam because they were on tour,
uh-huh.
and she coerced them into going out that night and to go to this place, Bananen Bar. The place that she had talked about wanting to do all the wild yeah. stuff. Yeah, she even said she needed her potassium.
Well, I mean, you do need that potassium. I mean...
Yeah, that's pretty funny.
So...
But okay. So while they're there at this Bananen Bar, apparently she kind of gets everybody to chant one of their names, and then that girl like finally caves and she does the things Lizzo's asking of her, which is like eating the banana out of the performer and catching dildos being shot out of them and making she made them like touch the nude model's body, and like, so sexual harassment. And they're saying Lizzo did this. And then another one is saying in the same lawsuit that she weight shamed her, and it's like all these what? Things are like the exact opposite of what Lizzo presents herself yeah. to be. So it's pretty wild, but
it's not shocking to me. I don't feel
right?
like, though, if it was somebody else, I'd be like, what? No,
right? It's just kind of crazy that like everything she's about, it's the exact opposite.
Oh, that is insane.
Yeah. So like two former employees actually came forward and they were like, no, we're not part of the lawsuit, but like totally that happened.
She also
to us
made
too.
Us get some potassium.
Yeah. So funny.
I guess they're suing for like damages, I guess, like emotional damage or like trauma or what?
Like sexual harassment.
Oh, okay.
And oh, dang, I'm going to have to look it up, but she's being sued for a bunch of different stuff.
That's, and how many dancers are involved?
Three of them are.
Nice. Dang, that's crazy. So they cave to the peer pressure.
Yeah, that's what they're
is
saying.
What's happened.
They're saying they didn't want to do it and that they felt uncomfortable.
They're like, I'm allergic to potassium.
And then Lizzo and then made him do it anyway. She had the whole club chanting the girl's name, and so she did it.
Oh, gosh. Mm-hmm. I mean, it would be difficult to refuse if everyone's chanting your name, right?
Oh, my God. I mean, if it's something I don't want to do at all, I'm going to be like, no, fuck that. I ain't trying to.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
If somebody cheered my name to get me to eat a banana out of a stripper's pussy, I'm telling you right now, that's not happening no matter how many fucking times you say my name.
They're like, damn, there's some other Tiffany's in here. Y'all bitches
crazy. You could
crazy.
Even fucking make up a little jingle about my name and everything. I'm giving no fucks. I ain't doing that shit.
No pistachium for me, thank
not
you.
Not for me. Not from fucking strippers.
Oh god,
that would be gross.
Too funny. Oh gosh, yeah, bitches be getting wild. Oh, especially gosh. Lizzo, huh?
Yeah, especially Lizzo.
But I mean, that's if anybody's getting that wild, that's who I expect it from.
Yeah, she do be getting wild. Yeah. Sometimes she's always been known for being like outlandish about things, but not ever in this way, you know?
Oh gosh,
that's so crazy. Oh, okay, but something else I saw the other day. This is not about Lizzo, by the way. So I was on TikTok, and I saw the most wild thing. There's this girl who, like, blew up, got super famous, because she does these lives where she flat irons a popcorn kernel to make it pop. And
does that work?
Yeah, it actually does. It's pretty cool. It's kind of mesmerizing, which I understand that's why she does it, because people are like, anticipation, like that fucking peeling egg.
Oh, yeah, that fucking peeling egg video. Sons of bitches.
I know you guys know what we're talking about. Everybody's got to come across that sometime, right? She goes live, and people send her these, like, roses and ice creams and dinosaurs. Mm-hmm. And every time one of those pops up, she says the same thing, because she's acting like an NPC, which is a non-playable character. Uh-huh. So an ice cream cone comes up and she goes, ice cream's so good. And she does that every time somebody sends her an ice cream cone. So she's making now doing this. She makes like $4,000 alive. And that's all that she's doing.
So,
like,
I'm assuming
she's
got
fully
no clothes
dressed,
on. What?
Fully dressed. Yeah.
Damn.
Just popping
people
popcorn
just
kernels.
Be spending crazy money on stupid shit, huh?
They don't even get to see no titties.
What
and
the fuck?
But apparently, okay, here's the deal. So they're saying that it's like people have an NPC fetish. Uh-huh. And that's what
it
is.
Oh, so it's still, like, sex related. It's still like, oh, I'm getting my rocks off watching this.
It's kind of weird, but at the same time,
kinda?
It's like, it's, well, you know,
that's
$4,000 alive.
A lot of
I'm
weird.
Like, ice cream is so good. I ain't even got to take my clothes off. I mean, I don't know. That sounds like a good deal to me.
God dang. People will spend their money on the dumbest things, apparently.
They really will.
But I mean, the fact that this girl was like, hey, let me get a little of that money for doing some stupid shit. Good for her, I think.
I think the most wild thing about it is she's gotten picked up by, like, the news and, like, national news sources about this. It's not just on TikTok anymore. Mm-hmm. Like, she's been on NBC News, and the New York Times wrote an article about her. Like, she's got stuff everywhere right now. Like, she's legit famous for this now.
That's insane.
And it's a trend now.
And
so other people, yeah, they're all jumping on their lives and fucking making money, though. Like,
yeah, I mean, who can blame them?
Something so stupid. That's just so dumb. You ever watched lives on TikTok?
No. I'll be honest with you, I don't even really get on TikTok.
Oh yeah?
Like I used to. Then you ruined it.
Why? How did I ruin it?
So I was working on TikToks, and I worked really hard. I was like, I'm going to start making some TikToks. And I worked really hard. I was like, I'll do a magic trick every single day, a new magic trick, TikTok. But the problem was I didn't know enough magic tricks to start off with, so every day I'd have to come home from work. I'd spend an hour and a half learning a new magic trick, and I'd spend 30, 45 minutes to an hour recording the magic trick.
You were really committed.
And then I posted it, and I did one a day for like two, maybe 2.5 weeks. And I got like 200, 300 views. And then one day, you drop a plate of food on the ground and get 200,000 views. I'm like, this is some fucking bullshit. I work really hard every day. So then I was like, fuck TikTok. So the bitches.
The funny thing is that video. So I was like, okay, Kyle's making TikToks. I can make a TikTok. And I had never made a TikTok before. So like, really, this is your fault. So I was like, what could I make a TikTok of? I love to cook things. Let me make this cool quesadilla hamburger thing that I like to make. And so I put it on there. I fold it up and it's all nice and neat. And I set it on the counter and I accidentally pushed down on the little crust and it fell completely off the table and hit the floor. And I said, oh no. And, and you got to watch the video all the way to the end to hear that. But I think that's what got people. But it went viral. It was ridiculous. And Kyle was so mad because he worked so hard every day on TikTok. Like, oh my God, it was ridiculous. I'd be like, please never stop with the TikTok.
You have to listen to the song 30 times. Just so you can line it all up.
So annoying.
Man, it's the worst time of my life. Don't do TikTok, guys.
Oh,
TikTok's
gosh.
Like a drug.
Or just drop some food on the ground. You'll go viral real quick.
Yeah. Fucking TikTok.
We should take a break.
Oh, okay.
Thank you to BetterHelp for sponsoring this episode. BetterHelp is the world's largest therapy service, and it's 100% online. With BetterHelp, you can tap into a network of over 30,000 licensed and experienced therapists who can help you with a wide range of issues. To get started, you just answer a few questions about your needs and preferences in therapy. That way, BetterHelp can match you with the right therapist from their network. Then you can talk to your therapist however you feel comfortable, whether it's via text, chat, phone, or video call. You can message your therapist at any time and schedule live sessions when it's convenient for you. If your therapist isn't the right fit for any reason, you can switch to a new therapist at no additional charge. With BetterHelp, you get the same professionalism and quality you expect from in-office therapy, but with a therapist who is custom-picked for you, more scheduling flexibility, and at a more affordable price. Get 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/thebarn. That's betterhelp.com/thebarn. This episode is brought to you by Copper Fox Contrived, located at 361 West Main Street, Park Hills, Missouri. Handmade gifts and wood flowers.
Looking for the perfect venue to host your next unforgettable event? Look no further than the Ashler, located at 316 West Main Street in Park Hills, Missouri. Whether you're planning a dream wedding, organizing a training event, hosting a thrilling trivia night, or even craving the excitement of a live concert, the Ashler is your ultimate destination. With its versatile space and personable host, the Ashler sets the stage for an extraordinary experience. Their dedicated team is there to bring your vision to life, ensuring every detail is flawless and unforgettable. From their stunning decor to their top-notch audio-visual equipment, the Ashler provides the perfect backdrop for your special occasion. Their experienced staff will work with you to create a customized event that exceeds your expectations. Visit theashler.net today to learn more about their exceptional service and reserve your date at the Ashler. What you got there?
An oatmeal cream pie.
Nice.
Thanks. What's your favorite snack cake?
Oh, gosh. That's hard. I always go back to the classic Star Crunch.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I feel like of all of them, I like oatmeal cream pies, too, but...
I do love Star Crunch, though. It's that texture.
Oh, yeah. Best texture.
Like a Rice Krispie treat.
Yeah, I like Rice Krispie treats, too.
I could eat 1,000 of those just for the texture.
Probably not the best of ideas.
Well, they're also tasty and delicious.
They are.
That crunch, though.
That crunch gives you diabetes like 4 or 5 in, I bet.
But it would be so tasty. So I don't know if I mind too much.
So you know something.
But that's not my favorite. But go ahead.
What's your favorite? Go ahead.
Those Hershey's chocolate cakes.
Hershey squirts? I think that's what those are called.
That's what that is. You're so gross.
Oh.
It's double funny because when I was a kid, My mom always used to tell me that chocolate was actually poop. She would say, when those big sewage tankers would go by, she'd be like, yep, headed to the Hershey factory. She tried to deter me from eating chocolate, but that did not work. Yeah. Oh, gosh.
Here we are. With the Hershey squirts.
You're ridiculous.
Those are pretty good.
Yeah, they are.
For poop cakes.
Best poop cake I've ever had. What was you going to say before I interrupted you with snack cakes?
Something interesting that I like about us.
Oh, what?
Something that we always do that I find funny is we do different accents in our regular everyday talking.
We do. I call it mockingbirditis.
Oh, yeah.
Well, it also might be some brain damage.
Yeah, because I don't hear random. Like the crazy accents throughout my day, but I still talk in them.
Yeah, I turn Minnesotan a lot.
Yeah, I always say stenko, stenko very much.
That comes from Grayson, our kids. Thank you.
Yeah, Grayson always said stank you instead of thank you.
So funny.
That's pretty good.
That was good.
And then we always do the Italian. I always go Mario. Mario's always my go-to. I'm always like, it's a me, a Mario. And now the kids have taken that and they say bad words.
They do. Because you let them.
No.
Yeah. You're the one who said the bad word first.
But they're like, can I say the bad word?
Yeah. And you tell them yes.
No, hell no.
Lies. Okay, so what do they say? What did you say?
I said, it's a me, a Mario. This is my brother, Luigi. He's a dumbass.
And Grayson thought that was the funniest thing he ever heard in his entire life.
You know what I like about it?
What?
Is then the Mario movie came out, and Luigi is a dumbass. Oh, yes.
That's a good movie.
Yeah, it was good.
Did you really like it?
Yeah, I'm going to be honest with you, though. I don't remember the ending of it.
Oh, Kyle.
I don't think I fell asleep, but I might have.
Hmm. Well, I couldn't tell you the ending of it because this brain don't retain.
I'm wondering, did we finish it?
I think so. I'm pretty sure.
I thought really hard about
I remember the end, but I can't tell you.
We can't say it. Yeah.
What would be a spoiler?
I'm going to have to watch it again.
I mean, it was cute.
And then once I watch it, I'll be like, fuck, I did remember this.
I'll remind you later what it was.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
It's funny that Mario is still as relevant as it is today, right?
There are a couple of things like that right now.
Like, what's the other one? Oh, Barbie.
Barbie.
We talk about Barbie all
Ninja
the fucking
Turtle.
Time.
That's because Barbie is iconic. And she's having a moment right now.
Yeah.
How can you not talk about Barbie?
Yeah.
She's everywhere. They just broke $1 billion in the box office. It's been in the box office for a week. It is the first ever only female produced and directed movie to ever break a billion, and it broke the world record of whatever was
really?
Before them. Yeah.
That's crazy.
Right? So, yeah. Fucking Barbie's
Damn.
Having a moment.
We were talking about Barbie before Barbie was cool.
We were. And we got the receipts to prove it.
Not me.
I'm stoked to see it, though. I really am. I know I keep saying it, but I can't wait.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, and then Ninja Turtles is coming back. I saw,
a brand
Beetlejuice.
New one. Yeah, Beetlejuice is coming back.
I think I saw a teaser that they might be doing Back to the Future.
Else. Yeah, I think I heard that, but there's another one that's like Beetlejuice, like from that era that I think they're doing again, like another cult classic like that. Who knows? I never know what the fuck I'm talking about. Yeah. Why do I even open my mouth?
So, what'd you do today?
Well, why are you looking at me?
I just think you're pretty.
Aw, thanks. I folded some clothes.
Nice.
I
think folding laundry is the worst thing in the entire world.
Really?
Yes, it's horrible.
I don't mind folding laundry because it is a repetitive action that I can do mindlessly.
Ah, I absolutely hate it. And I hate putting it away.
Oh, putting it away is fucking.
I liked that as we put our clothes away, we both said, well, hopefully I never have to open this drawer ever again. Like shoving it in there, like, oh no, this is gonna be a pain in the ass tomorrow morning. I can't open that drawer or the one above it.
Do you think that means we have too many clothes?
Yeah, probably. No. And that's the problem, is like, I'll go to throw something away and I'm like,
I might wear it.
I might need that for something.
I'm the same way. Mm. I'm definitely a hoarder when it comes to certain things.
Oh, yeah.
Like everything.
I think, yeah. I like
I
to
try
say
so
we're
hard
hoarders,
not to be a
hoarder. But of cool stuff, but
not always.
I think that's what all hoarders say.
Yeah. They're like, look at this box of fucking trash. It's so cool.
Look at these used spoons I've got here. Haven't been washed in a couple years, but one of these days I'll get around to it.
Oh gosh, newspapers. Why do they always keep newspapers?
Oh, I don't know. That's how I decide I'm not a hoarder. I just throw away the newspapers. I'm like, I clearly don't have a problem. Right?
It's not in me. I threw that away.
And then anything stupid, I'm like, I'm going to need this for sure.
Right.
Every cable I find, I'm like, this plugs into something.
Absolutely.
And one of these days, I will find out what it is.
I hate the cord buckets.
I don't have any cord buckets, but we have that cabinet in our kitchen that I just set everything on top of.
I know.
And then you transfer it to buckets.
Well, I've got doom boxes and you've got top of dressers, and that drives me insane. I'd rather them be in a cozy little box, never to be seen again, than snaking down.
Yeah. Well, if I see it snaking down, I won't forget it's there.
Oh, I see. Okay.
And then we're going
to
be like, oh,
method
I saw that
madness,
somewhere.
Huh?
That's always the first place I look. Anytime I've misplaced anything, we're like, better check the mystery cabinet.
Every time. Oh, my. And you lose things so easily. You lose everything.
But I'm always the one to find it, though. You never help me.
I'm
always left alone to find it on my own.
I don't think anybody believes that.
Well, it's true.
I think every woman in the entire world knows how
Listen. Okay. Oh, you're over here every single day, every 15 minutes. You're like, where's my vibe?
I didn't say I don't lose things.
Where's my vibe? You know what? I haven't been in a few minutes. A douchebag. Where's my vibe?
God, you're so jealous of me.
Yeah. So jealous.
Oh, gosh.
I feel like you lose way more stuff than I lose.
That is not true. You have a bad habit of like saying, okay, no more electronics, child. You take it away, you put it away, and then when you're like, okay, you can have it back, then it's like, where is it?
And then I'm like, not my problem. I didn't lose it.
Yes, you did, though.
Not my fault. Y'all made me take it away from you.
You never know where
it's
you
push
it.
It's your fault for pushing the limits, being mean kids.
And then I got to wander all over the fucking house playing this game.
It's always
like,
in like,
where would Kyle put things?
I like that at some point I'm always like, did you kids steal the shit back? I know one of you little fuckers has it.
You're just really good at hiding things.
Yeah.
But you're also very forgetful.
Yeah. Well, we have to hide things good from our kids.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, they steal our shit. And their shit.
They do, those little frickers.
Yeah. What the hell? So you gotta get good at hiding things. So good, you forget. The thing is, if I remember, they're gonna talk me into telling them.
they're
gonna be like, where the fuck's my phone, Dad? You piece of shit.
I don't think that's gonna happen.
Oh. They're gonna waterboard me until I tell them. It's in the cabinet in the bedroom.
Yeah, no, that's not gonna happen either. I think you'll be all right.
Okay. I just assume one day our children will be terrorists and I'll be the first waterboarded.
They might already be terrorists. They just aren't using those tactics yet.
Yeah.
Thankfully.
Yeah.
We're safe for now.
Mm-hmm. What did Grayson say tonight? Oh my gosh. Oh, I don't remember what it was. Anyways, the ice machine broke and I was taking it out and fixing it, and he came in. He's like, you know what Jackson need to do is.
What?
I'm like, bro, you don't know anything about ice makers.
Oh, what you actually need to
do. He said, what you actually need to do is. Like he knew how to fix the fucking ice maker.
Grayson thinks he can do absolutely anything.
It drives me insane. I said, dude, you don't know jack shit about the ice maker. Get the hell out of here.
But that confidence, man, that's going to take him so far in life.
Yeah, to prison.
No. Look at you. Look at me. We're both overly confident people.
Yeah.
Look how cool we are.
Yeah, we're so cool.
We're on a fucking podcast. It's a cool.
Yeah,
we
fuck
are.
Those motherfuckers. fuck all those people who said I wouldn't make it. I bought this podcast equipment to record this on. Fuck you, motherfuckers.
So yeah, that's where he gets the confidence from.
That's true.
We can't really blame him. We created this monster.
Oh yeah. Nobody wants to see Marshall no more.
Oh, no.
All right, we should go to a break.
Yeah. Thank you to BetterHelp for sponsoring this episode. BetterHelp is the world's largest therapy service, and it's 100% online. With BetterHelp, you can tap into a network of over 30,000 licensed and experienced therapists who can help you with a wide range of issues. To get started, you just answer a few questions about your needs and preferences in therapy. That way, BetterHelp can match you with the right therapist from their network. Then you can talk to your therapist however you feel comfortable, whether it's via text, chat, phone, or video call. You can message your therapist at any time and schedule live sessions when it's convenient for you. If your therapist isn't the right fit for any reason, you can switch to a new therapist at no additional charge. With BetterHelp, you get the same professionalism and quality you expect from in-office therapy, but with a therapist who is custom-picked for you, more scheduling flexibility, and at a more affordable price. Get 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/thebarn. That's betterhelp.com/thebarn. This episode is brought to you by Copper Fox Contrived, located at 361 West Main Street, Park Hills, Missouri. Handmade gifts and wood flowers.
Looking for the perfect venue to host your next unforgettable event? Look no further than the Ashler, located at 316 West Main Street in Park Hills, Missouri. Whether you're planning a dream wedding, organizing a training event, hosting a thrilling trivia night, or even craving the excitement of a live concert, the Ashler is your ultimate destination. With its versatile space and personable host, the Ashler sets the stage for an extraordinary experience. Their dedicated team is there to bring your vision to life, ensuring every detail is flawless and unforgettable. From their stunning decor to their top-notch audio-visual equipment, the Ashler provides the perfect backdrop for your special occasion. Their experienced staff will work with you to create a customized event that exceeds your expectations. Visit theashler.net today to learn more about their exceptional service and reserve your date at the Ashler.
Guess what else I saw?
What?
The dumbest fucking thing I've ever seen in my entire life. There are people now claiming to identify as RCTA.
RCTA.
Yes.
RCTA?
No. Race change to another.
Oh, damn. These people are going to get canceled.
Yeah, they are. But like.
So they're saying that they're a different race?
Mm-hmm. And they're saying. If
anybody that wants to be white, you're more than welcome to be white. Like,
yeah,
we can't say anything.
I don't think that's going to be a problem for us.
Oh.
I don't think anybody really kind of wants to be white anymore.
Sammy Sosa does.
One and only. I bet now he's like, damn,
fuck.
I regret this.
I fucked up.
He's like, now I'm a white guy. Fuck.
That was crazy.
Yeah, but anyway, so race change to another. Obviously, these people are a little off their rocker. But they're saying, okay, they're saying, I don't even want to say this because it's the dumbest thing ever. They're saying if transgender people can identify from one sex to another, then why can't we identify from one race to the other?
I mean, what do you even say to that?
I don't know, but it feels fucking gross. And I don't like it.
I don't know what I can and can't say about either of these peoples.
I don't think we have to comment on it. Yeah. You know what I mean? I think we can just be like, here's some information I saw about that. And my personal feelings are not going to be broadcast here.
I mean, I like NASCAR as much as the next guy.
What the fuck does that even mean?
You know, racing.
Are you saying you're...
No. What I'm saying is we're talking about racing here, right? NASCAR racing.
Yeah, NASCAR racing. Okay. Yep, that's what we're
talking
about. Called?
Race what?
Race change to another.
Race change to another.
And like people are getting like surgeries and shit to what become kind of Asian, like getting,
don't
you know,
say
eyelids.
You can't say that.
Say Asian.
Oh gosh. I'm getting canceled.
That is definitely politically correct.
Are they going by Asians now? Okay.
Stop. That sounds so racist. All right. Oh, good.
So people are getting surgery now?
Yeah.
Like, but what other races are they doing besides Asians?
From white, of course, these fucking white bitches out here,
it's
doing dumb shit,
people.
You know what I mean? Goddamn white people.
And Sammy Sosa.
And Sammy Sosa. So these white girls are like, I used to be American, but now I'm Hispanic.
Not with an accent like you at that, you ain't, honey. So are people trying to cancel them like all over the place, or are people like, hey, what?
Yeah, people are not happy about it. In fact, people are making a lot of videos of their own claiming to be RCTA, but it's just making a mockery of it, basically. So like they're doing the most. Oh, so they like to do this thing on their videos where they put mom nationality, dad nationality, me nationality, RCTA new nationality.
Oh.
And so they had one that was like this person of color, this young black girl, and she put on there that her mom used to be white. Her dad was white. Her original nationality is white. And clearly that is not what has happened here.
Okay.
And now her new nationality was black. And like, that is not how that worked. That is absolutely
not. She got top and bottom surgery. Eh?
She got whole skin surgery. Just unzipped it, took it off. Got new skin. No, but it's just a joke. And there's like all kinds of little words on the screen just fucking making fun of it. Basically saying RCTA people are a little ridiculous.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know anymore.
I don't know anymore. Where are the aliens? Just fucking come get us already.
Yeah,
we're tired of this place.
I mean,
I need a vacation from Earth.
The hardest part is whenever I get into space and the aliens have me and they're like, what do you identify as? What the fuck do I tell these people?
Whatever you identify as. That's what you tell them, you weirdo.
But what if I tell them the wrong thing? I end up in the wrong group.
Oh, no. I don't think that's how it works.
I'm
Are
like,
you unsure
I'm a hot
what
lesbian
group you
woman.
Belong to? You're so dumb.
I identify as a super hot lesbian woman. Put me in that group, please.
Well, you know, I think they're going to not go for that.
That's what, excuse me, aliens?
Why are you trying to leave me if we get abducted by aliens, by the way? Wouldn't you be like, I need to be
in
that
in your
super
group,
hot,
right? Hot
MILF group?
Lesbian woman.
Oh, gosh. I think they'd throw me in with the MILFs.
Yeah. I'd be like, I identify as a MILF as well. The thing is, like, how judgy are these bitches going to be on the spaceship? You know what I mean?
Who knows?
They're like, no, I don't think so, motherfucker. You're over there with the bears.
Oh, good. Yeah, you would be.
Like,
not a
fuck.
Bear. I think they call you a cub.
No.
Yeah. So, like, the bears are much bigger men. Bigger and hairier. You're not, like, bear status.
Oh, well, what the hell?
You're cub status.
No.
Yeah.
I think cub is the one who gets fucked by the bear.
No.
100%.
No.
I'm like 100% fucking
true.
Sure. How much you want to bet? I'll bet you $1 million fucking dollars right now.
You don't have $1 million, but if you did,
I'm not gonna lose.
Take that fucking bet. Okay, I'll take your bet. Oh, God, you're so dumb.
I'm about to win $1 million.
No, you're not.
I'm about to win $1 million. Oh, yeah. Tiffany's wrong. I'm about to win $1 million.
You better shut your face.
I'm right, right?
A younger or younger looking version of a bear is called a cub. Cubs are often younger or less mature or masculine looking. The term is sometimes used to imply the passive partner in a
relationship.
We're both right. We're both right.
No.
We're both
right.
Right. No, we
wrong.
Are both right.
You owe me $1 million.
No, we
Fuck
owe
y'all,
each
I'm
other.
Out. I'm a millionaire now.
$1 million.
I'd like to thank all y'all small people who helped me get here.
You're so stupid. You're so dumb. Why do I even put up with you? Oh, God. You know what's terrible about this?
What?
How many people are going to say, oh, my God, Kyle's so funny.
Yeah, that's the worst part about this whole thing.
It's fucking stupid.
Yeah.
Could you not be so, like,
I'll
charming,
try not to, but I'm
handsome
not
and hilarious.
Promises. Yeah, it's pretty difficult for me not to just, you know.
It's really kind of like fucking up my vibe. Tired of it.
Yeah.
I bought this stuff to put in my tea, and I absolutely love it. It's so fucking good.
What is it?
So I like those skinny syrups that you can put in your coffee to flavor it.
Uh-huh.
And they're sugar-free and they're like zero calorie. Well, they make fruity ones too. Mm. So I bought a Meyer lemon raspberry.
Meyer, then, like Oscar Meyer?
Yeah, Oscar
disgusting.
Meyer Wiener. It's got hot dog juice in
fucking
it. That's why
disgusting.
I bought it, obviously. And then there's also a regular raspberry. I don't know if I said that or not.
Oh,
but tonight
that
I
sounds
the,
way better than the Oscar
the hot
Meyer.
Dog one oh, in mine tonight. It's delicious.
Mm.
Very salty, but good. Just kidding. It's not salty. It's delicious.
Yeah. This episode brought to you by the salty deliciousness of Skinny Syrups Fruity.
Skinny Syrups Fruity. That's what the line is called. If you guys are looking for it, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
Skinny Syrups Fruity.
Yeah, get that. Hot dog flavored water scent.
Just make sure that you don't type in bear, cub, and fruity at the same time because you're going to find something different.
Oh, yeah.
Don't forget to erase your previous searches. Also went to Brickhouse Social tonight.
Sweet. What'd you do there?
We did some duck pin bowling. We had dinner and then we did a little karaoke because apparently on Mondays now they have karaoke.
Nice, nice, nice.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, I like that duck pin bowling. It's pretty fun.
That's like my favorite thing ever. And it's so funny because anybody I tell about duck pin bowling, they're like, what is that, first of all? Okay, it's like miniature bowling, but all the pins are on the string. And that's what I tell everybody. I'm like, but the coolest
the
thing...
The part about it being on a string doesn't even have anything to do with the game.
It's so fucking cool. I know it doesn't, but it's just like the coolest part to me because when the pins go back up to reset, they get pulled up on these cords, and sometimes they get tangled like little marionettes. And I just like watching
that
it.
That is a fun part of it.
It's very satisfying. But yeah, duck pins, super fun.
Yeah, it's a pretty good time. Pretty good time.
And those little cannonballs. They just fit perfectly in my hand.
Yeah, a little shot put.
I've never shot put anything, so I don't know. Oh. Have you?
In school, yeah. You never did that, the shot put?
I don't think so.
On like track and field day?
Do I
you
look like I was
day, huh?
Track
like, not for me, guys. There'll be no track and field. I got a doctor's note from my mom.
That's right. Yeah, I didn't much participate in those types of things.
What a loser.
I was. I wasn't a loser. I was just lazy.
Those are like my favorite days. That was always so much fun.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
That's nice for you.
Yeah, it's a good time. Good time. But now every time I go duck pimple, I just want to shot put that fucking ball through the TV.
Well, probably don't do that. Yeah. I think they'll kick us out for that, for sure.
Yeah, I think about it every time, though.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You got a real problem.
Yeah.
I just want to break shit.
We should do one of those rage rooms.
Yeah, I think you would benefit from that.
It looks like so much fun.
Honestly, I think everybody would benefit from something like that.
But I feel like I'd go in there and be like, man, this little TV is kind of cool. I can't smash that.
Yeah, you little hoarder. Be like, oh, I can take this home.
I'm just going to break this. Can I just have it? If I don't want to break it.
Yeah.
That's a nice vase.
Yeah, that would be me. I could put flowers in this. Better not break it.
Yeah, I'll just set this over by the door. I'll grab it on my way out.
I would definitely do that. You ever stolen cups from a restaurant?
Never stolen.
Wow. Just bold-faced lying to me, huh? Everybody's stolen something in their life. Get off your high horse.
I stole your heart.
You fucking cheese ball.
Have I ever stole a cup from a restaurant? So, yeah. So, whenever I was like right out of high school, I worked at Ryan's. My mom also worked there, and every day I stole a cup. I would just get something to drink. Our whole fucking
every day.
Every day I took a cup from there. Almost every once in a while, I'd bring it back though.
That's why they're no longer in business.
Yeah, it probably is.
And there
was a kid who was
cups.
Throwing the pans in the fucking trash compactor.
No.
I told on him though because I'm a company man.
Oh no, you fucking snitch! Oh no.
Listen, he was throwing away all the pans, and like he was like, "Oh, this one's too tough to clean. Throw it in the trash compactor."
No.
And then it was like, "Hey man, we're fucking running out of pans. Hands, bro, you're making my job difficult." So then I told on him.
Oh no.
Yeah, and he got fired. I was like, fuck that bitch.
Ooh, damn, daddy.
Yeah, good.
I like it when you tell me douchebag stories.
Oh yeah, I was such a real douchebag, telling on people, getting them fired.
Yeah, I mean, it's not really a deal. You did what you had to do.
Yeah, he shouldn't have been throwing their stuff away. Like, that was costing the company money.
Yeah, definitely.
Those cups, I brought most of them back. I probably kept 4 or 5 of them. I'm sorry to Ryan's corporate if you're listening to this. I apologize. I didn't mean to do it.
Well, you did, but at least you brought them back, right?
I didn't bring them all back. I mean,
Piece of shit.
Anybody wants to buy some Ryan's cups? I still got a storage shed full.
Wouldn't that be funny? You would definitely be the person to have a fucking random storage shed full of Ryan's cups.
I know
cups.
One of these days I'll use them.
And you would be the person for me just now to find out 8 years in. Like, the fuck? What?
So that reminds me of that time mine and my buddy's garage was right next to the Charter building. And they decided to move the building somewhere else. Well, instead of taking half their shit, they just threw it in the dumpster. So there's a dumpster full of like TV remotes and power cords and shit. And I was like, man.
Boxes and boxes and boxes.
So many boxes. I was like, surely these are worth something. And I dug them out of the dumpster. And I brought them to my house.
Mm-hmm.
And I let them sit there for like 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
And then I listed them on eBay and I sold one of them for $4.55.
Mm-hmm.
And it cost me $5 to ship. Not really. I just made that part up.
Wouldn't that be funny though?
So, and then finally I was like, fuck. And then I threw them in our dumpster that we pay to have dumped instead.
Yeah. That's so smart.
Yeah. I was like, hey, guys, don't worry about these. I'll throw these away in a couple years for you.
Just ridiculous, man.
You never do anything like that? I mean, sometimes you just happen upon a deal in a dumpster.
I mean, I have dumpster dived, and I'm not above it. I'd still do. If I walked down the street today and I saw something fucking cool as shit outside, I did that to the neighbors back there.
Oh,
they had that big dresser, and I stole it and refinished
it. To clean it.
Oh,
they
whatever.
Weren't even giving it away. She just stole it off
I
their porch.
I smashed it. No, just and I refinished it so they couldn't tell it was theirs. Yeah, I've done that a couple of times in my life.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes it's just good shit for free.
You know what I would love to do?
What?
I would love to dumpster dive out back of like a Sephora.
Oh, yeah.
Which is a makeup store.
I bet they break that shit.
Well, they're supposed to, but like Sephora.
And if they don't break that shit, I bet
everything.
The employees go back there and steal that shit before anybody else
has
the chance.
Yeah, that's probably
true. They're like,
true.
Let me put this in a bag before I throw it in the dumpster.
Isn't that so ignorant that they break the stuff before they throw it away? Like, there are battered women shelters that they could be donating that shit to instead of breaking it up and fucking throwing it away. That's so wasteful.
You ought to send that out to Sephora, tell them that.
I should. I should be like, listen here, motherfuckers.
Yeah, I'm trying to help you, motherfuckers.
First of all, give me a couple before you send them.
I personally go in there and I'll gather up all of that makeup.
I'll transfer them for you.
You lying ass.
They'd get there. Whatever. I love, this is going to sound so, you know, what's
racist.
The word? No! Yeah. This is gonna sound so like a humble brag.
Oh yeah, do it.
Yeah, do it.
Humble brag. Tell them what you do, baby.
So when I worked at Jimmy John's, I opened that store in Farmington, and I was the one that started them on donating their day old bread to the homeless shelter because they were just throwing it away.
Nice.
And it was like 40 loaves a night of their long ass French bread that they would just throw in the dumpster. And I was like, we could be donating these to the shelter in Bon Terre or anywhere. And they were like, we can't do that, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, I'll even fucking set it up. Like, this is ridiculous. Do not throw this food away. So I called the shelter, coordinated with them. They even came to pick it up. Like, Jimmy John's didn't have to do anything but put it in a bag.
Nice.
And they still do it to this day.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I just think being wasteful like that is ridiculous when there are people in need who could use the things, you know?
At Ryan's, they used to throw away so much food. You had to weigh it before you
That's
threw
disgusting.
It away. One time they threw away like 20 pounds of fried
That's
chicken.
That's fucking ridiculous.
Yeah, it was insane.
What is wrong with the world that
fucking
we would
Ryan,
rather see
you piece
things?
Of shit.
Yeah, fucking Ryan. All
fucking
Ryan's,
that little 8-year-old
you know?
Kid. Ryan's World, fucking closing out Ryan's restaurant.
Yeah, what the hell? Do you think they had conflict in naming? Do you think one of those people got a cease and desist letter? Ryan's and Ryan's World?
No, that's two completely different things.
You think so?
I don't think you can really copyright a name like
yes,
that.
Yes, you can.
You can copy... Kyle, that's
for
my...
For marketing usage.
From now on, everybody listen up. Kyle, my name. Nobody else use that shit.
You're going to have to...
You use that shit, pay me a dollar right now. Cash at me a dollar if you want to use my name.
Like even just to say it?
Yeah.
I'd like to talk to you?
Yeah, I need my royalties.
What do you want me to start calling you? Baked beans?
No, I want you to call me Kyle and I want you to pay me a dollar each time.
You're not fucking doing that.
God.
I don't even call you Kyle now. Only on here.
That's a dollar right there.
You ain't getting
Fuck, I'm going to be rich by the time this thing over. I already made a mil.
A
now
mil?
I made a mil and a dollar.
Where's all these millions you have?
You lost that bet, bitch.
Oh,
you owe me $1 million
no.
Now.
We,
$1 million.
Lose
$1 million.
We canceled each other out because we were both correct.
No, you weren't. I was correct.
No, sir.
The fact that
listen,
the cub
the
gets
Google does not
cancels
lie.
Out what you said altogether.
No, it doesn't.
Yep.
Hey, don't be so dumb. And put your eyebrows down when you're talking to me. You have the most expressive eyebrows.
Thanks. I used to practice
yeah,
in the mirror.
It looks like it.
Do eyebrow exercises. I'm like, motherfuckers better put in the work.
Kyle is one of those people that cannot control his eyebrows.
Oh, you can tell what kind of mood I'm in by where my eyebrows are at on my face.
Usually they're in his hairline.
That means I'm pissed off.
Oh, good. When he's excited, they're up there.
Mm-hmm.
When he's upset, they're up there. When he's happy, they're up there.
When I'm surprised.
Real wiggly things up there.
Yeah. it's hard to control them sometimes. They just do whatever they want.
Mm-hmm.
One time I looked up, they were doing the wave across my face, just like at the stadium.
At least they're not like thick and bushy like Eugene Levy's.
Yeah.
You got good brows.
Oh, they grow in perfect, just perfectly white trash like this, just like Joe Dirt's beard.
All patchy.
Nah, these some good ass eyebrows. I get compliments on these eyebrows all the time.
I don't feel like that's true.
Uh-huh.
People just come up to you and they're like, hey, you got good eyebrows.
All the time.
That's fucking weird.
All the time.
That's a lie.
They're like, god damn, there's some nice fucking eyebrow. Fuck.
Why are you so full of yourself?
No, so for like for real, I used to. Every time I'd get my hair cut, people would be like, man, you got nice eyebrows.
Really?
I'd be like, thanks. I grew them myself.
That's my line, you piece of shit.
Nah. Takes a lot of time to shape these eyebrows.
Oh, yeah.
Spend a lot of time tweezing.
Do you?
Fuck no. That shit hurts.
Sometimes
makes
you
me
gotta.
All teary-eyed. Every once in a while, I got to pluck just right in the middle.
Yeah.
And man, it hurts every single time. Got to rub some ice cubes on there first or something. Numb it up.
Oh, no. Come on. That's ridiculous.
You know what they say? Beauty is pain.
You'll know pain until you've had your pussy wax, okay?
Yeah, I can imagine that sucks.
God. When I was a teenager, I hate saying that. Dude, that makes me feel so fucking old. When I was younger.
Back
like
in the old days.
You know? Yeah, I hate it.
Yeah.
Anyways, way back when.
Yeah, back in the olden times.
Yeah.
BC.
I was probably like 17, 18, and I bought one of those do-it-at-home wax kits, but it was the hard wax, so it didn't come with any strips. The wax itself was the strip.
Oh,
like you put it on, you let it cool, peel up the edge, and rip it off, right?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I thought I was going to be cool. I thought I was going to wax myself, you know? So I get in front of the mirror, and I put the wax on, and I peel up an edge, and I couldn't even lift. I couldn't start to pull, because as soon as I like did a little tug test, you know, it was like, you know, and then I was like, no, that's not happening. Like I tried and it just was not going to happen. I didn't actually try. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
it was
just like,
nope, that hurts too much.
So then you just had to wear that wax till it fell off, right?
So I had to hot shower it off, but that's too funny.
Oh, yeah. I could imagine.
That's a core memory.
I could imagine that would be horrible.
That sucked.
Like, and once it's on there, you're like, fuck,
yeah,
what am I gonna do
really
now?
It was a while. Like I had that on for a while because I was like, because I was trying to hype myself up to do it, you know. I was like, I can't just be stuck with this. What the fuck am I gonna do? Like, it's gotta come off, you know. But I just couldn't bring myself
that
to do
sounds
it
horrible.
And then eventually I was like, fuck, I hope it comes off in the shower, and it did. So
I don't think I could ever do that. That sounds like the worst time ever.
Yeah. But I've had my eyebrows waxed. Not bad.
That hurts too, though.
Just for a second. Mm. It's just like a, and then it's done. Mm. What are you, yell
makes
Kelly Clarkson
all twitchy.
When you get yours done?
It's like, I'm not crying.
Gosh.
I start spasming.
It's so funny the amount of pain that a woman can handle compared to a man.
The thing is, there's difference. Like, I could smash my hand in a fucking car door and be like, fuck, that hurts.
Me too.
But then you pluck my eyebrows. I'm like, why does that hurt so bad?
I can smash my hand in a door and be like, fuck, that hurt. And pluck my eyebrows and be like, that ain't no thing.
But yeah, I definitely think women can deal with pain much better than men. I will definitely never argue that point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's gotta be the truth.
Gotta be.
I think men are stronger than women in a lot of ways. But when it comes to some physical pain, it's weird though, you know, because I do feel like you could probably take getting your ass kicked better than I could.
Yeah.
But I could definitely wax whatever without being a pussy-ass bitch like you.
I think there's just maybe certain things that women have built up like a pain tolerance to, and it's been like an evolution thing maybe. I don't know, though, because waxing is a fairly, I wouldn't say, within the last probably 20, 30 years, right? For sure. I would say even, yeah, probably 20 or 30 years.
20 years? No. That's, no, it goes back to, like, further than that. They've been,
they had that full bush.
They did.
Full bush in the 80s, so the 90s would have been, like, 40 years ago.
Shut up.
I know. That's crazy. Nah, that's been around since, like, the 90s. Yeah, baby, that's 40 years.
The ancient Egyptians around 1150 BC removed all their hair from their armpits to their pubic hair using sugaring.
Dang.
Which is waxing.
Sexy-ass Egyptians.
That's fucking wild.
Sugaring?
And then the 1960s is when they had the wax strips. So it's been since the 60s. But you got to think, like,
they
were waxing legs and armpits and mustaches and eyebrows.
Yeah.
Yeah. They still weren't waxing there.
Yeah, everywhere, but.
They had a little Bob Ross between their legs. You know? It's a happy little tree. They got a new Bob Ross show out.
I saw
that.
It's
got Owen Wilson in it.
Which is weird.
Blonde.
Yeah, that, like, son of a bitch.
I know. His hair
with his
wasn't
light
blonde.
Hair.
Like, why would they do that? Like, he's most famous for his brown afro.
Yeah.
Would it be brown? Yeah. Light brown.
I don't know. Listen here. You've
dark
been telling
blonde.
Me you're blonde your whole life.
I used to be. And then I dyed my hair. Okay, before I started dyeing my hair, I was like a dirty dishwater blonde.
You know, like a light brown. No. Light brown blonde.
No.
Medium brown.
And
medium
then I
brown
started
blonde.
Dyeing my hair. And when my roots would grow out, they would be blonde. Mm. Not like fucking platinum blonde or anything.
Yeah.
But now that my hair is all virgin hair, it's all brown. I don't know.
Virgin hair. Honey.
You so stupid. What do you think that means?
I'm just kidding. I know what you mean.
You're dumb.
Hey, everybody. This is Tippy.
And this is Joe.
And you're listening to the Tippy Jo Show, sponsored by BetterHelp.com/The Barn. If it's all right.